It's locked. It's locked, all right. So Harriet Jones became the original carrier when Edgar gave her vampire blood. I must tell Elizabeth.
Place for a stroll. Sir, step away. Get him with us.
What good fortune brings you back to me, Jonathan? What is it, my dear?
I'm afraid it's bad news, Elizabeth. The worst, actually.
Please, speak up.
Edgar is no longer in McCullum's grasp. I resolved that matter.
Where is our good friend now? Is he well?
Of a sort. His injuries were mortal. I had no choice but to make him one of us. To save him. Or to punish him.
To punish him? I fail to understand. And what is the source of this cold tone in your voice?
Edgar Swansea was responsible for the Skull epidemic, Elizabeth. It was he who unleashed the deadly scourge upon London.
What? Are you certain? This is the most terrible accusation of all.
He confessed everything to me. He sought to cure the disease, to exploit vampire blood to stop the epidemic. But he unwittingly gave birth to a catastrophe.
All those poor victims. How could he do it? What happened?
Edgar gave no heed to ethics. His theory could have been proven to be correct, but he abused the confidence of his patients to test it.
I must say, I'm shocked, Jonathan. Who would have thought it? And the poor patient. Let me guess. It was Harriet Jones, was it not?
Yes. That explains how Doris Fletcher was infected, and how she became an Ichor. She secretly visited her mother at Pembroke.
Then we have no choice. We must act quickly, Jonathan. We must return to the sewers and put an end to the threat poor Harriet embodies.
I have one more matter to discuss with you. Harriet Jones was the primary case, but do you know what a healthy carrier is?
There is a tone in your voice that frightens me, Jonathan. What are you trying to say?
It was your blood Edgar used for his experiment on Harriet Jones.
What? No. No. This can't be. Oh,
Elizabeth. Are you all right?
No, I have to go.
What do you mean?
Leave me alone. Save the city, Jonathan. Save what can be saved.
Elizabeth, I need answers. Why did your blood
cause
this?
Stay away from me. Please. I swear I never was your enemy.
Wait. No. Elizabeth. Now would be a good time to blend the recipe Marshall used when he fought the disaster. I think I know where to find what I need.
Your mind, Corbin!
Thank you.
Whose blood could be purer than that of William Marshall? Lord Redgrave will have to spare me a drop. I'm still persona non grata in the Ascalon Club. If I want to speak with Lord Redgrave, I'll have to improvise.
Good evening, Lord Redgrave.
What are you doing here, traitor? I shall smite you for this audacity.
I'm not here to bicker, Lord Redgrave. I can put an end to this epidemic, but I need your assistance to do so.
Good. We've held out thus far, but the time has come to put an end to this crisis. Tell me, what do you need?
The blood of William Marshall.
The blood of William Marshall? Of my maker? Are you mad? This blood is the purest of all. My maker proffered it to me on the battlefield. I cannot hand it to you.
Stop this farce. Marshall never was your maker. I have no idea how you acquired his blood, but I need it now.
I see. Well, in that case, given the gravity of the situation, I suppose I can spare you a drop.
Thank you, my lord.
If you manage to save this city, you'll prove yourself a veritable servant of the crown. So godspeed, Dr. Reid. Our fate lies wholly in your hands.
Thank you.
is! Your mate!
I cannot use garlic, but there may be a substitute in the Pembroke Hospital drug storage. There it is. Insulin. Much more efficient than garlic against blood poisoning and sepsis, and much less dangerous for me. Thank you, Dr. Polescu.